Hi, it's Mike from testnet.io. I'm here to show you how to get started with Codecept.js test automation and the manual testing under the one roof of the test management system. Let's just get started a new project. So probably you have test automation in place already, like I do have on my local box. On the remote box, so and you would like to import and synchronize your test cases easily without customization. So how to make this done? You go to the import of the source code. You can choose the Codecept.js and JavaScript, for example. Then we will generate a special command that you would need to execute on your test automation repository. So once your test cases are introspected and all the test cases are sent to test management system, you may see that you see the folders like you have in test management and like in test automation repository. You can open the test case and you can see the implementation of test automation. Fine then. So now we have the automated test cases synchronized to test management system without kind of customization. So now let's just create a new manual test cases. We will create a new test suite. Under this test suite, so let's just create some test cases easily by checklist. So one line is one test case. Easily, we can create 10 test cases. Now we can describe these manual test cases with descriptions. So for these descriptions, we will use the auto-completion from our steps database. For example, I open some page, I click on some link, and I see that some text is present on our page. Of course, I can add some supplementary information like screenshots from the buffer. So we'll save it and we will have it. So we have a description, we have a code template, some kind of attachments, so history of the changes and so on and so forth. Fine then. So now we have the manual test cases and a test automation under the one roof of test management system. If you are feeling that you would need to organize your test cases somehow, you can use the drag and drop, right? So to put the appropriate order of your test cases, or even more, for example, here. So if you would like just to move from one test suite to another, so you just can drag and drop from one test suite to another, and you will see that this manual test case is moved. So you can organize in a different way. So you have different filters, you have the different tags you can use and so on and so forth. Fine then. So we have organized our test cases and now let's go to the test execution. Fine then. So if we have the test automation in place, let's just easily execute all our test cases. For each of the frameworks, we have developed the special reporter that should be installed on your test automation repository. It's done already on my site. So, and then you would need to add the configuration to your test automation here on our site. So I do have it already installed. So here I do the plugin installed, right, with the reporter, and its reporter will be used when I execute my test cases. So all I need to do is just execute this regularly with this API key. So let's go and execute our test cases. We see that this reporter has been started to execute. So we will see that test case is executing. So we will see, okay, so in real time, you can see that results are flowing to test management system. So you don't need to wait until the end to see the results. So you can click on some test cases and see what exactly was executed. And if you have some failures, you can go inside and check, okay, so you have some stack trace, you have some screenshots, recordings, and so on and so forth. After the execution, the video recordings also will be added here. So at the same window, you have the code implementation, some attachments, some stack trace, screenshots, or video recordings. So fine, so we have test automation execution in place. So let's just execute the manual execution. Fine then, on one side, you have the test cases you would need to execute. So you can mark this passed. Failed, so you can type the message and you can add some screenshots here, so from the buffer if you would need to. So fine then, and we will use the shortcuts to quickly mark our test cases as passed or fail, and then we have two results of the test automation in place, so we can check the results, right? So we can filter the results and check, so what was failed and by why reason. So you can check the video recordings, for example, fine then. And from another side, you have the manual execution, fine then. So you have the test results in place. Good, so once we have it, so you can go and check the analytics. You can check the coverage by test suites, as you may see. Fine, so you can check what defects do you have, right? So you can check them some defects. So you can see the flaky test cases, the slowest test cases, and all other types of the analytics report that we have. So by using the testmat, so you can easily integrate the Codecept.js test automation under the one roof with manual testing, and you can use our advanced features like steps and database. You can describe your test cases easily and then use the auto completion during the description. So you can use the pulse. It's kind of the audit log of what was changed and what exactly was done in your project by whom and when. So you can check the analytics, you can use the branches for the manual test cases. Of course, you can add the continuous integration. So if you would like to, or set up some reporting notification to email or Slack or MS Teams or any other, or make some integration with JIRA. So please use testmat to integrate your manual test cases with Codecept.js test automation easily in one click.